But not big names, right? The only big name he was what's his name? Nicholas. Nicholas. Yeah, Walker Nicholas. That was a good fight, though.
No, I'm on the same boat, but I'm saying, you know, he still beat a lot of guys.
Yeah.
Crawford should be number one right now.
What do you think of Mikey against Errol Spence Jr.?
That'd be good if Mikey gets a strength trainer and.
Hey. He wants you. What happened, Pita? He doesn't like your work.
No, I like the work. It's because he got fired. Now he wants me to get fired. Fucking dick.
He says my dad said that he wants him to cook for me again.
Yeah, that's what he said. That's what he told.
And my dad said that he looked better when I looked better when he was cooking for me.
My dad said that.
Yeah. He was lying.
And that we definitely need a condition coach, that because I look soft. I didn't look strong.
I don't know. Did you would have to ask Robert on that one.
That's what he said. That's what Frank said.
I love Frank.
And then we need a cook.
What? You know, he does need a strength coach trainer, doesn't he? Like, to get him more bulked up? What do you think?
Wait, what's Mikey's record?
I love this.
What's Mikey's record? How many belts does he have? How many titles?
But you don't understand, Elie. You're not at the camp all the time. You don't know how.
You're not at the camp all the time. You were there.
Because I broke my arm. But listen, whether you believe it or not,
you're not at the camp.
Are you for next camp?
No.
Yeah, what? I love you.
Doing what?
Huh?
He
asked me, hey, bro, can I go paint your fences? I can do the trivia.
Talk your shit. I don't care.
No, so what are you going to do with that?
Nothing. You're not going to do anything. Not for mine.
You're not always there. How are you fucking camp manager? You're not always there. You're always there every day.
So what?
I'm there every day.
He's only there in the between 8 and 12, and then from 9 to freaking he goes to sleep.
I'm there every day.
So wait, we didn't answer my question. Errol Spence Jr., Mikey. So you said only if Mikey gets a strength coach?
Mike gets a strength
that's
coach.
That's it. Mikey, that's the only requirement.
And
he
stays focused. But here's why. Because the strength coach will wear him out, and Mikey's runs, goes, works out, strength coach.
Why? What does he do right now?
Goes to the gym, goes home, and relaxes.
What does he do right now? He doesn't do that?
He travels. He goes on 4x4. Drives, he does a lot of
what about the Ouija board? What about the Ouija board?
He does Ouija board. Yeah.
You said everything went bad since the Ouija board, huh? All the bad broke your arm, you didn't even play.
The Ouija board? Fight got postponed.
It was because of the Ouija board, not because you were trying to get sexy in the shower, Frank.
You're a fool. Come on.
Which one was it, Frank?
No trying to get sexy.
Frank, we're live right now and someone says you look like Buddha sitting on that rack.
Hey, look, the street coach trainer, I think if Mike has one and he stays focused, hey. When he had Daryl and he was staying focused, Mikey would only eat, sleep, work out. That's all we have time for. Every time you called him, I'm tired.
If it's not broken, don't fix it.
And now he's not tired
anymore. If it's not broken, don't fix
full
it.
Of energy, aren't you? Little bunny rabbit, the energizer.
Winning, right?
Frank, you weren't even there in this cab.
Well, fuck you.
You're winning, right?
You weren't even there.
Yeah. But time for fun. Yeah, I know you. He's having fun to your boxers, but he's had his fun, Robert.
Frank, they say you're the Samoan butterbean.
Crack the whip on him.
You're fucking knocked the guy was right like 160 probably fight night.
Hector Tanahara says hello.
He went away in the day.
Hey, tell
never
Hector,
been dropped
he was
in
there
his
when
life.
I lost the belt. Is that senior?
Yes.
Yeah, I tell senior because he told me, what's wrong with you? I said, nothing. And I was on my phone. I was scared, dude, when they told me the belts. Oh, my heart dropped. I was calling everybody. I didn't say nothing to nobody. I just ran to the hotel and waited for the belts. So Hector, that night, I lost Mikey's belts. That's why I looked all tripped out.
Mikey, tell everybody what happened. We're live right now.
Fight night after the fight.
4 hours.
He's going back to the hotel room to go bring my belts and whatever, and fucking leaves on an Uber.
An Uber.
Takes off. And leaves the belts in an Uber.
4 hours it took.
It took him 4 hours to finally track him down and get him back.
5 in the morning.
But for that time, how are you feeling, Frank?
I couldn't sleep. Well, I was standing outside. I was pissed.
4 hours?
Why did you have a heart attack?
Took some Vicodin just to relax.
Are you high right now?
No, I've been with Mikey all day.
Take the glasses off. Take the glasses off. Take the shades off.
I'm not high, fool. I've been with
him. Let's see, Frank.
I'm not high.
He's high as fuck.
I've been with him all day.
Hey, what
do you think about Manny Pacquiao saying he wants the Lomachenko fight?
That's good. He should get that fight. Why shouldn't he? That would be good. You know what? Manny's still a top pound fighter.
No.
What?
Manny's fighting Lucas Matisse.
He beat Jeff Horn. He beat him. That's
fighting Lucas Matisse.
It's done, right? Lucas Matisse?
That's what I told Mike. It's done. Hey, but he beat Jeff Horn. Pacquiao's still on the top. He's still.
Mikey, you're like a big boss status right now.
Don't forget the 100 you owe me and then the gas money. What the fuck? Huh? Is it all there?
Frank. Why is Frank straight to the library. Straight to the library. You're going to have a good day today.
Why is Frank getting paid?
He's taking us. He's treating the team.
Mikey, how do you like that he doesn't trust you and he has to count the money? That's the kind of insulting.
Should I check them too? Make sure they're all freaking real. Oh, I seen him get an old bank. He's gonna buy a razor right now.
What kind?
Top of the line, turbo.
You're buying a razor? Might stop buying shit.
No, he needs it. It'll be good. End of the road happens, you're covered. You can go anywhere you want.
Frank, how happy are you right now? Because all your life you just want money. And that...
2 months of freaking pay of bills.
Working good.
How happy
why'd
are you?
Why'd you go to the dealership? Go look at
he's counting it a second time, Mikey. Oh, Mikey, he's counting it again.
I didn't count it all the way.
He lost count. He did. That's all. I was about to show Big G the pictures you sent me, Mike. And tell him, oh, this is why he's not. This is why he isn't here. He would have fucking had a fucking. He would have killed this.
Frank is balling. Is that enough? Do you approve?
Give me. Let's. Hey, tell Vasily if we could get Mikey's logo on his boxing trunks. I'll pay him right now a sponsorship.
What do you want? Wait, say that again. What do you want?
Mikey's logo on Vasily.
Why? So you can sue him?
Sponsorship. No, sponsored.
Like you did Joseph Mikey. Parker? You said Joseph Parker?
I didn't
Parker?
Sue nobody.
Change your title.
Mikey's
I'm suing you.
Talking about suing me now. He said he wants to sue me because I want to sell shirts and sweatsuits and hats.
No, I said you can't do that.
I said I could.
You can't do that.
Huh?
You can't do that. I told him he can't do that without my permission.
No, it's your
he
name.
Yes, I can. He says, fuck yeah, I can. I'm like, no, you can't. I'm like, if you do, I'll fucking go and post that. Please do not buy anything. You know, it's not authorized.
The parents know me already.
You can't do
so
it.
Oh, he's a celebrity now, Mikey.
Frank is a celebrity.
Hey, in Texas, you got a lot of love.
Yeah.
A lot of people are looking for you. You're walking down the aisles like a pimp.
Yeah, it was cool. Some hot chick came up to me. Some hot chick came up to me, no. I went to Hooters. I went to Hooters.
Yeah, right.
No. Hot chick came up to you and what?
And she was like, are you Frank? And I'm like, yeah. She's like, I don't have my phone with me. I said, all right, fine. She had big tits, too. She got
right there. We're live, Frank.
Well, maybe she's on. Hey, hit me up. What is that? In a cockroach. Okay.
What?
Right there on your back.
It's a beetle. Are you afraid of bugs?
Yeah.
Spiders? Yeah. Ants?
No.
Mice?
I'm getting your room next time, Frank.
Huh?
I'm gonna get your room.
Where? Downstairs? I got kicked out. I was in the bottom. That's why I left.
Mikey, by the way, you heard Triple G saying that he thinks Canelo was dirty in the first fight, and he said that the hand wraps were bad and
retards.
I wouldn't go that far to claim the hand wraps and all these other things, but I don't know. You have no evidence to sustain that, you know, that claim. So.
But here's okay. Canelo failed the drug test, but ever since he's been tested 4 times, yeah, he's been clean.
He's gonna be clean. The fight should be on. I don't think it should be.
ESPN is reporting it. It seems like it's gonna be postponed, but
yeah, I don't think it should. I think they could get it done. I mean, if he's clean between the period that he tested positive and all the way through the fight, then. What's the problem?
How do you make sure the meat that Frank the Cook gives you is clean?
I buy him high-end shit. I don't buy him shit from Walmart.
Frank isn't his cook anymore. We give him.
I don't care, whatever. Yeah, no, I do care.
What up, Frank?
You have to look
up.
So wait, are you suing the hotel that you slipped in the thing?
No.
Why not?
Who's asking?
Because it was Ellie's, it was his own fault. He was trying to get sexy. In
doesn't matter.
How did it happen?
I told you how it happened.
Tell everybody we're watching.
I slipped and I
what
fell.
The fuck?
Why
not?
Did I?
I think so. It's
no, I didn't fall.
They came when you came.
Yeah?
Yeah. I smell shit.
I don't smell.
They came when you came.
Oh, man.
Wow, they're giving refunds to people who bought tickets for Canelo Triple G2. What do you think, Timo?
They should offer refunds.
Yeah, why?
Fight. Well, here's the thing. What happens if you ask for a vacation off of work and you find a babysitter and then you buy tickets and then they 2 weeks before the fight they cancel or a week before, hey, we're canceling. Give it a time so fans don't get mad.
What would you do in this situation, Frank?
You put Anthony Joshua.
Anthony Joshua to replace?
Yes. On that fight, yes. I'm being serious.
So
I'm being
serious. Could be a pay-per-view here in the United States?
Well, on Cinco de Mayo.
Lost. Mikey just fought. He's covered. Mike's the best Mexican out there. He's not doing anything to promote it. Everybody should be stop talking about Canelo and his positive and look to the next best Mexican fighter, which is Mikey. So, I mean, I don't know what to say. Who else is
Are you going to let him introduce you for the next press conference?
He asked me.
Hey, how are you? What did he say?
If I could let him be the one to introduce me and talk and represent me.
Frank, how would you introduce Mikey for the next press conference now that he has the first American ever, only the third fighter in history to win those titles?
Just like that.
Okay,
but
say
I would
it.
Say it more and more enthusiastic. Okay. Can't do it right now, man.
Why not? This is your audition.
He's a suit.
No.
You're 200 people watching you live right now.
It doesn't matter. I can't do it on the spot. I would just prepare myself.
No. You failed.
Pita, hold this. Oh, yeah. Take over. I'm the
king of this shit.
Right away. Yeah, people do it on the fly like that.
Pita, if you.
I'm not
if you're a real artist, he has you to let him do it, right?
Mikey, how does it feel to have all four belts now? Now that you got your belt.
He
Mike,
all the belts got smashed.
Khabib time!
I almost lost them all.
Fuck you.
Never lost them in the ring, almost lost them because the chef
is a fucking Uber. Fucking Frank.
You got it back, though.
Mikey, when are you fighting in Dallas?
What are people telling you, Ali? Everybody's keep talking about Canelo, but why don't they?
Okay, only two fighters on the planet have called out Errol Spence. Mikey and Amir Khan. Why is that? How come nobody else is calling out Errol Spence?
Who's calling out Errol Spence?
Mikey Garcia and Amir Khan.
Oh.
Nobody else.
Mexican Ferguson. Tony Ferguson's not Mexican.
But Frank said I need a strength conditioning coach.
Leave Fat Frank alone.
Well, come on, man. You're...
Frank the Mr. Potato.
At least 10 pounds of muscle to gain it properly. They
really
know what they're doing.
I really need it. You really think so, Frank? Like, honestly, not.
Yeah, because it keeps you more focused and you'll be a better, people will see a better you, yes.
10 pounds of muscle. Frank.
Because you're not focused.
Elie Seckbach fears Mario Lopez.
No. What's a tougher fight for Keith Thurman? Is it Crawford or is it Danny
Ferguson? Ferguson is a Mexican, bro. Stop.
Crawford,
no, he's not.
Why?
Because... Crawford is more
yeah,
technical.
I bought what a pita was
from
both.
And
Benavides.
He's just more complicated to fight.
Terrence Crawford to Mike Garcia tape. Hey, Mike, you guys have the recorded the fight, you versus Crawford?
No.
Yeah, we got to record it at the house.
What do you mean?
Not at your house, but at the ranch. It's recorded. What, his fight?
The amateur fight you did?
When he fought Terrence Crawford in the amateurs.
What do you
remember
from
that fight?
I thought
you had that recorded.
It was the U.S. Championships in Colorado.
See, that's why Mikey hasn't called him back. Called him back out for what Crawford did. Crawford got a lot of retweets for what he did, right? What did
he do?
He called Mikey out on Twitter.
Well, Pita called him out. What do you tell Crawford?
Yeah,
Pita, tell people.
I think he got that from me.
Yeah.
Pita started it. Crawford.
What did you tell Crawford?
I don't have the video of that shit. He said, you weren't even there. I was like, yeah, I was. That shit was gangster. You guys should have been there. Yeah. I was just talking shit. I didn't say, I've never seen a fight. I started that shit. So we're with Crawford, and he's like telling me all this. I'll fuck up Mikey. I'm like, bro, Mikey will beat the shit out of you. Yeah. I'm like, Mikey will fuck you up, and you know it, and this and that. And Brad, I think Brad was there. And then he's like, I already have two Garcias under my belt in the amateurs. I was like, bro, it's not the amateurs. You can't run around for three fucking rounds like you did. He's like, I ran around for three fucking rounds. He's like, were you even there? I was like, yeah, I was there. He's like, have you ever seen that? I was like, we got that shit recorded too. We don't have it recorded. I wasn't there. I was like, fucking five.
Yeah, so he went on Twitter.
I started this.
Go on Twitter and read.
Yeah, it was on Twitter.
He fought Danny once, and they put up the video one time. But I don't know if it was Danny, but they tagged me as if it was me.
Okay.
But it was
a lot of people confuse you guys.
Yeah, Pelos
fought
him too.
It wasn't us. It might have been a Danny. I don't know. I couldn't tell. There was a video that I saw one time, but
there's also Pelos also.
Pita, you stand up, dude, for asking about the tape.
And
beat the line hitting cousin Crawford. Yeah, the video. Oh no, the video on the line just at the end.
Rainbow, bro.
But yeah, we were there. No, but it wasn't like we weren't like really talking shit to each other. Crawford's cool, dude. We were. Oh, go.
With Crawford.
I'll talk about it.
And
I was already pro.
When they did the meeting before, they said they told us all, every coach and everybody. There are going to be three rounds, except for
Tony Ferguson and Mexican.
The
shut up.
The finals are going to be four-round fights. The finals.
What happened to Pelos? I don't know.
This is their first fight in the tournament. Pelos versus Crawford.
The first.
The draw.
Yeah.
You know, Pelos fights Crawford the first fight. first round comes out, and there's and that's when they were doing the score
points.
Points, and yeah. They were showing the corner the scores. So they came to us the first round, like 2-1, pelos. Then second round, they come to us, and pelos was like 3-2. Pelos was always ahead.
But very, very small.
Yeah, because they don't, you know, they only score like real good punches.
And like, and there's like three judges. Two of them have to score the punch, the same punch. It's weird. Some shit like that, right?
Second. So, bottom line is, Pelos was ahead in the second round. So, after the third round, they show us, and Pelos wins 4-3.
Yeah, he won every round.
4-3. Well, it's by score, not by rounds. So Pelos wins. So I took off the Hager. We're like, we won. You know, we beat Crawford.
Not that big of a
deal. He was one that people, you know,
amateurs, there's guys that go into the tournament. You're like, okay, these are the guys we know.
He had done some good tournaments before that.
So they tell us, no, it's a 4-round fight. I said, no, the fucking meeting was
3 rounds.
3 rounds every fight until the very finals. This is the first fucking fight of the tournament. Like, no, you have to do one more round.
Yeah, I love Brian Ortega. That's my number one guy right now. But fuck, Tony Ferguson is a Mexican. Chill out with that.
So then Crawford won like
stop saying that. Go listen to him fucking try to speak Spanish.
Crawford like 4 or 5 points in that round.
Tony Ferguson.
He could win. And then after that, every fight was 3 rounds. Until the finals, they did it for us. So only for that fight, they made us do.
I wish I was there.
Because Pelos had already won.
Can you imagine if I recorded it and posted it?
He's not Mexican, stop. He might be from birth, but he's not Mexican, you know what I mean? Like, fuck, Frank's not Mexican either.
No, this is true. Pelos had already won.
I know, but what did you say afterwards when that happened?
Yeah, Mikey, if I read you, don't worry about it, soon.
USA Boxers, wait on it. Because they said, no, you know.
Small Frank, see, fuck you.
It was a 4-round, and then the rest of the tournament was all 3. Until the finals, then they did 4 rounds. But they made us do one more round, just because Crawford was behind. And he had lost. But then they score like 3 or more points on him, and he won by 1 point.
Some people thought that that was me fighting again, and they'll claim that he beat me twice, but it was one.
So it was my fault that he tweeted that shit. It was my fault.
Take credit when the fight happens.
Yeah, I made that fight happen.
You made it happen.
No, but yeah, but look, some of these guys right here on ISIC are saying, oh, you weren't really cussing on Crawford. We were, but it was like we weren't really talking shit. Cause we were laughing the whole time, and then he like just tapped me on the shoulder. He's like, hey, what's up? He's like, you know, he taps me on the shoulder. He's like, hey, what's up? I was like, oh, what's up, champ? I had met him one time before that, I think, right? And so he's like, I was like, what's up? And I said, champ, I think. And he's like, hey, you know, I'll fuck everybody up in auction, right? And me just being an idiot, I was like, if you're talking about like Lomachenko and all their camp, yeah, you'll fuck them all up, bro. I was like, cause we're not in Oxnard anymore. We're in Riverside now. He's like, oh, you guys in Riverside. He's like, I'll fuck up everybody in Riverside. I was like, shut the fuck up. No, you won't. But the whole time, you could see in his face, like, it wasn't like, oh, me talking shit to somebody. We're mad. Like, you could tell from his face, like, and I was like, shut the fuck up. No, you won't. And Brad Goodman was there. There were some other people there and stuff, like, whatever. And then he's like, who do you name one guy in your gym that would have a. Pita hates Ferguson because he left RGB. He was never at RGB.
Who?
Tony Ferguson. And he was like, and I was like, stupid Tony Ferguson was at RGB. And I was like, no, you won't. And then he's like, name one guy that would even have a chance with me. And I didn't even mention a name. I was like, you know who will fuck you up. I was like, you know who will fuck you up. He's like, name one guy. And I was like, you know who will fuck you up. And obviously I was talking about Mikey. Mikey's the one in his close to his division and all this and all that. Whatever. He's like, I already have 2 Garcias under my belt in the amateurs. And then that's when I was like, you can't run around. I don't even know how the fight happened, right? I was like, you can't run around for fucking 3 rounds and win a decision in the fucking pros. I was like, it's 12 rounds, little ass gloves, you'll get knocked out. And then he's like, the fuck you talking about? I ran around for 3 rounds. You were you there? I was like, yeah, fuck yeah, I was there. And then he's like, shut the fuck up and this and that. I was like, we got the video too, and this and that. And then he's like, then post that shit, then post it. And then I was already like, fuck, oh shit, we really don't have the video. And then I just kept talking shit.
There. He did run around because that was the system. And like Mikey said, look, we started off wrong right away, the first and second round.
We had never seen him before. We didn't know
who he was
or anything about him. So we see tall southpaw, and he's moving around. So I'm coming forward, and at the end of the first round, he's already up like 4-0, first round. So then,
because you know, because moving around and boom, you know, you move around and when they're doing this shit, that's all they're scoring. Right. That's all they're scoring.
So we come to the corner and my dad actually told us, he's like, hey, we're fighting the wrong fight. We're falling into his fight. We're chasing him and that's what he wants. But then my reply was, but I'm already down 4-0. What the fuck am I going to do? If I don't follow him, he's just going to run around
and win 4-0. Because that's what
that's the way you score.
They didn't score rounds. They scored points.
Yeah.
So I kept trying to catch up, but he just kept
Mike scored a few. He scored more.
He really outpointed me.
But he was okay. Moving around
what
all the time.
If you guys meet in a pros in six
that's
months.
A whole different thing.
What do you mean 6 months?
I don't care where he was born. I don't care if his parents are Mexican. He's not Mexican. Have you ever heard him speak Spanish? He's not Mexican. Tony Ferguson.
I wouldn't be working.
What is
he says Mexican is Frank.
He's a white guy.
Tony Ferguson. That he's Mexican.
Tony Ferguson. I know.
His Mexican heritage. Like, but he's not fucking Mexican. Fucking Brian Ortega is fucking Mexican. Brian Ortega is gangster.
Why can't he just answer yes?
I said fucking
Tony Ferguson's never been to Mexico.
6 months. Everybody wants to fight soon, but this kind of fight, you needed a marinade. You needed right now the way it's starting.
Mortal 2400. There's videos on Elie's page already talking about Belize and stuff. We should just talk about that right now.
To get balls to get out of top rank. Because it won't, not going to happen.
No, it still happen. When the fight's worth the money, they'll work together.
Frank, this guy's asking, where's the butt at?
It'll happen.
I don't know.
Did you respond to him on Twitter?
He looks at bio right away. Frank burned y'all. I was like, hey, this guy in here is asking where's the butt at, and he looks over at you.
I put up the video of Spartan Joseph Bonus.
Yeah.
It has like 81,000 views, and all the comments are like,
is Joseph like in jail?
I don't know. Where's Joseph Bonus?
Get over here. What are you on? Who's live?
YouTube. Elie, YouTube
live. Live right
244.
I'm going to get you a new
tool. So what about the
takeover? Here's a takeover right here. What's up, you guys? Here's a takeover. Hey, I'm going to get you a tool. This lady's bringing, she emailed you your Instagram. It holds your phone like this. Listen. Listen, Elie. It's going to help you. It holds your phone like this, and you can connect your camera. You're going to hold your phone.
Look at Robert. No, you move. I gave him my phone in San Antonio, and he was blocking the
light
with his finger, and he said, Elie, your camera's dark.
Oh, my God. You're complaining
that my phone's dark. Right here at RGBA, everybody's done training. Jam's empty. Look at Mike. Right there. Watch it. Let me see. Empty gym. Everybody's out here talking boxing. Gepito Wedgie, what's up, man? I don't do that shit. Ask Robert. Danny's in RGBA. What Danny? What's up, you guys? Here you go. Behind the scenes, RBA, RGBA. Elie Seckbach, Robert Garcia. Pita, Louie, look at Mike, back from Belize. Hey, Mike, how many mosquito bites did you get? Everybody wants to know. Can you show them?
I didn't get one, Mike.
What's up, what's up?
Oh, yeah, yeah, that's right. We got a couple.
Right here.
I didn't get any the whole trip.
You guys get ready for April. Ososito's fight.
We're playing soccer outside in shorts.
Yeah, Tony did take my sponsor. Now, he took my idea for the sponsor, but that's about it.
What happened?
Tony took my idea for a sponsor. He didn't take my sponsor. He took my idea. Tony, the Tony here. Tony, the whatever his last name, yeah. He didn't take my sponsor. He just took the idea for the hot sauce. He was here when we were talking about the hot sauce, so he put 2+2, and then he got the thing. I'm not a hater. Frank Apparel, make it happen. I am. Hey, when's Josecito fighting, Mike? What day?
April
28th. You guys on Fox Sports 1?
18-0.
On Fox? On Fox? Damn, Josecito.
No, las con aquel toca, Mike.
Okay.
Mike, you're going to send me over there to the fight, right? Mike, you're going to send me to the fight? Ow, King Santos. Billy Joe versus Triple G, Robert.
Oh, Billy Joe, he only beat, what's his name? Lemieux, and looked really good. But previous fights, people say he lost to... that other guy that does movies. With tattoos, yeah, Russell.
Oh, Russell.
So if he lost,
I think that was Martin Murray. Who lost
people say that, he lost to. No,
shut up, Javier. Fatso, that's all you can think of, bro. Come on.
Everybody said Rosado beat him.
Your mom likes it when I talk, bro. Sanders.
So, by one good performance against David Lemieux.
What's up, Geronimo?
Can't say much. I think
Geronimo.
Triple G wins. He's gonna have two or three of those wins.
Yeah, if you have a tough.
Because if you just had against Lemieux, who's always, you know, strong in front of people, you could box the shadow of him easy.
I never seen anyone.
Okay.
Yeah.
I
get to be Mikey Cook. Hey, tell him, see what he says.
Who's
that?
Hey.
Nah, it's
just a friend.
Oh.
Nah, it's just fucking
get Mikey a honey sponsor. Mikey pays $80 for a honey, bro. Pizza Hut, bro. Pizza Hut. Domino's is
you
cool.
You want to make pizza?
No. Yeah, I can.
Why don't you open up a pizzeria?
I'm going to open a faux reel. I'm going to make pozole. Pozole, that's what I'm going to cook. Just pozole there.
That's how you're going to sell pozole?
Javier Diaz, you want to spar, bro? Why you want to spar, bro? I spar in the street. That's what I do. I don't spar in a boxing ring. Spar in the street, bro. Whether you believe it or not, I don't give a shit, man. Stop hating, bro, because I'm here and you're there. A bunch of haters, bro. Ow, tajin for your beans. You ever eat beans and put tajin on it? It's good. Hey, tajin on your beans. Pizza in San Antonio, it was okay. Mike, oh, what was that pizza? Did you like it?
Send me that. Save it, send
it. The one you ate before your fight. Was it good?
Tajin, Frank?
Tajin's good on the beans and ice cream.
Ow,
beans off my belly. That's tight, man. You guys are original. That's gangster. What's up, Frank? From Del Rio, Texas. What's up, Del Rio? Let's see. Come on, man. I cook good. What are you talking about, man? Shut your mouth, man. We can't do manteca and stuff for Mike. Yeah, I gotta take a run over a car. Who's Josecito boxing? What's the guy's first name? Miguel Cruz? So watch out, man. We're coming hard. We're gonna pump Josecito up. We all believe in him. He's gonna rejuvenate Josecito Lopez. Can I get shout out from Mikey? Hey, Mikey, can you shout out? Can you shout King Khan? Shout out King Khan.
He's a native.
Yeah.
When is it?
He just admitted that he's from there.
Mid-May.
No, I don't know Mika what? Mika.
Like
Mika Mote?
Aloha.
Shout out from Santana. Orale Santana. Hey, Mike, can you get a shout out to Pakistan? Shout out to Pakistan. Ow, fire. Fire in California. I don't know. Where does it show it? 300? I don't know. Where does it show it?
279.
All right. Live with me. That's good. I'm taking over Rainbow's job. But Rainbow gets mad at me all the time when I say stuff. She thinks I'm putting her down. Hey, Arizona, what's up, man? I was over there in Tombstone, bro, and Bisbee, Arizona. That shit was tight. Say Michoacan. Orale. What's up? Shout out from Silmar. What's up, Darren? What's up, Darren? Where are you guys from, Joey? Bakersfield. Ow! Bakersfield. Hey, you don't even know. Somebody called me. Somebody burned somebody for $1,000. I don't want to say no names, but they call me.
You can share the story when
you're
done.
Yeah, share the story when I'm done. They call me up too. Remember the cell phone? They call me up for the money. Rubs Frank belly for good luck. Orale, only if you're a girl you can rub my belly. Come on, bro. Tacos de verga for pita. Ow. Nice hat. UFC hat. He got that from Dana White. Dana, hey. Right there, Dana White. What's up, Frank? What's up, Florida?
They're fucking touch with that dude.
Alex from Silmar. What's up? What's up? How you guys doing? Hey, you guys.
Whatever we want, he says. Whatever we want.
They have a big fight in New York. Let's go.
When do we have?
I will. Shout out from Portland. What's up, Oceanside? San Antonio. some fun in San Antonio. I eat some gorditas. Birmingham, UK. What's up, Watsonville? Orale, vato locos por vida. When is Gomez fighting, Robert?
Gomez fights April 12th.
April 12th. Fantasy Springs, you heard it right there. Gomez is fighting. Hey, they want to know about Corrales. Was he the hardest puncher?
Corrales hit really hard, very hard, but I think the hardest puncher was Ben Tacky.
All right, you guys heard it there, right there.
Who's the weakest puncher you ever fought? Anybody you fight that had no power?
Joshua Parker. Hey, I say to move that Parker fight to Cinco de Mayo, but that's on me. What's up, Fernando? No, Philippines, what's up?
Yeah, I remember.
Dalton, Georgia. Hey, I went to Georgia, bro. Them peaches are expensive. What's up with that, Noe? Hey,
hey, we have a new kid. Future.
Shout out from Yakima, Washington.
Really?
Culiacán, Sinaloa.
Where's he at?
Right? He's in there.
What's up? Hey, somebody's watching us from the fence. What's up, bro? Somebody's over here on the fence. They're saying they're watching us from over the fence.
Where?
Over here, so yeah.
So these guys are our fans?
Yeah.
I don't think so.
Yeah, he just said it right here.
Oh, shit. Time to raise his hand.
What?
Maybe from over there.
From over there, maybe?
I'm watching you from over the fence to your right. What's up, man?
To your right? Caesar.
Let me see a comment.
Caesar. Caesar Ramirez.
Caesar,
yeah, what's up, Caesar? Look at Robert's looking for you. He says he's over here.
Where's Caesar?
He said to the right. Hey, Caesar, you got a gun? Shoot it or something.
He's tripping.
Caesar, no, he wrote it right here.
Yeah, they're lying. We're all looking like idiots. He's making
it. No, he's not.
Yeah.
And see, they're calling you me a liar, bro. Come out here. Wave your hands up in there like you don't care, Caesar. Mikey, where are you at? Come on, make some noise. What's up? What's undercard for Triple G Canelo? Whoever's on steroids is fighting. Steroid card? No, I'm just kidding. Hey, you guys got to start asking about Canelo and focus on Mike now. Mike's the number one Mexican boxer in the world. You guys need to refocus your energy and focus on Mike. Even though everybody says Mike does this and picks his own fighters, you guys got to stop hating. Mike fights the best because... Hey, Lipinitz was an IBF champion, and Mikey fighting. Mikey is a natural 130, 135 pound fighter right now, and he moved up twice in a row, and look at what he did. You guys got need to stop talking shit already. Yep, Mikey is the best. You're right. Crawford Garcia, 2 years. Who? I'm not a kiss ass. So shut up. We were arguing all the way over here. Tell Mikey to get in the gym.
Yeah. Bro, just relax.
He just got off the fight, bro. He's not going to get in the gym right now.
You're right.
Frank has to wash his underwear twice after enchilada night. Come on, bro. I can handle beans and rice, bro. I can handle beans and rice. What I can't handle is your mom. No, I'm just kidding. What does Robert think of Ryan Garcia? He says he's a good fighter, good promoter.
He's done a good job. And,
beat the drop the ball on him.
He fucking...
beat the drop the ball on him. He could have been over here.
14-0-39.
You dropped the ball, bro. Just a minute. You dropped the fucking ball. He did.
Well, stupid, fool. Nah, Ryan's a real...
Yeah.
He's been here a few times. Nah, he's doing his job, man.
I heard Pork Chop wants him bad, though.
In the future, those are future.
Pork Chop says, hey, give me Ryan.
You know, we have Gomez, we have Tanahara, future fights.
Hey, I watch Ryan's videos. The only thing I think he messes up, he calls out the wrong people. He called out Tank and even said, I'll fight Mikey.
So
that's stupid.
That,
he shouldn't say that.
Him fucking more people following him. He's doing the right thing, dude.
He shouldn't be calling out Tank.
Respect, you got to respect what Ryan's doing, bro. You got to respect what Ryan's doing, honestly.
All right.
And when he goes in the ring, guess what? He fucking knocks him off.
Out. Oh, you're right.
He's knocking motherfuckers out. 14-0 with 13 knockouts.
But you think he's gonna go good with the trainer he has?
Dude, he's already going good. Why not?
But to the high level competition.
Why? Let's wait and see. Why not?
But wouldn't your knowledge help him out better? I'm being serious. Your knowledge.
My grandpa wasn't a well-known trainer. He got my dad and Fernando to where they got. And he
this
wasn't a well-known
junior.
Trainer.
This is our future.
Right,
Chavez Jr. from
Culiacan.
You like body shots? You're lefty?
He's fucking Spanish, boy. He's from Culiacan.
Is he lefty?
No.
Ain't Chavez Sr. was a lefty, wasn't he?
What's his name?
Wasn't he?
Hey, no, listen.
I said, wasn't he?
Listen.
Escobar.
You didn't hear Frank? He's like, this is the next Chavez Sr.? You're a lefty?
Wasn't he? But he was no. Wasn't he low? Wasn't he known for his left hook for the body?
But that's not a lefty.
I don't know.
Lefties are like this. This is righties.
All right. But it was his best punch, right? His left hook to the body.
He's 18 years old.
Shut up, fucker.
9-0 with 9 knockouts already.
Wow.
I'm telling you, that fucking power he's got.
Ah, that's nice.
Hey, can you punch?
Mikey, Bakersfield loves you, Mike. Mike, Bakersfield. Flat Earth. There's no flat Earth, bro. If there was a flat Earth, the Earth wouldn't turn around. Come on, man. Tired of people saying flat Earth.
He doesn't speak.
There ain't no flat Earth. There is no flat Earth, bro. Sorry. What's on sale at Albertsons this week? Al, screw Albertsons. They let go of me. They fucked up. They could have had one of the best cooks in the world. Fucking, yeah, right. Mexicano. Mexicano.
From East LA.
Orale.
The look he's going for.
From the head.
Yeah, from the barrio. Simon. Mikey, you're a coward. Come on. How is Mikey a coward, bro? He gets in the fucking ring and fight. Come on, guys. Stop talking shit already. Why are you watching if you think he's a coward anyway? Come on, man. Mikey is... You guys don't even know the crazy shit we do in camp. Ow! Why you hate? Oh, you hate me, San Antonio? That's fine. As long as you like Mike, that's all that matters, bro. That's all that matters. I'm not anything. I'm just behind the scenes. So I don't care if you hate me. Hey, what's up, Angel? Shut up, huh? Angel Cantu. You have a sister named Veronica? You could eat the carne asada Fridays all day, but spread it out through the day, and you should be all right as long as you're running. Make sure there's avocado on it. As long as you're not eating too much of it, like at one time and eating something else, but no, it's not bad. Yeah, my wife's a gold digger, bro. Yep, you're right. That's right, bro. I know hating on San Antonio. San Antonio's tight. Shout outs to Roger from San Antonio.
He got sanctioned.
He helped out a lot over there. Flat Earth, it's in the Bible. The Earth's not flat, bro. It's round. Come on. The Earth wouldn't turn around every day. There wouldn't be night and day if it was flat. Think about it. How would it be?
There we go.
Oh, he said
he fucked up the ref.
He fucked up the ref. That's what we should have done in Puerto Rico.
That's a good story.
We should have done that in Puerto Rico, right? Hey, he fucked up the ref. Because he's...
Yeah, you're right. I can't cook. You're right.
And he fucked up the ref.
Don't do that in the pros.
No,
that's
the same professional.
Diferente. Are you a big fan
of
Chavez?
Yeah.
Why? The best ever?
¿Por qué?
Ah, pero es el mejor de la historia para mí.
Thanks, Jesse.
Have you ever met him?
¿Lo has conocido?
Sí. Sí,
what did he tell you?
Entrenar en el gimnasio con Rodolfo, con el hermano
de él.
With his brother, yeah. So you're excited to be here. Feliz.
Video games are flat, but our 3D people are starting to think. Come on, bro. Come on. He's not going to spar me. I'm pretty fast, Ellie, just so you know. That's Lou. Where's Louie? Hey, am I fast? Am I pretty fast? You fucking liar. You liar.
Why don't you shadow box? You'll see him fight one day. You watch. You're going to see him fight.
Look at this smoke of felon. Kid
can really fight.
All right, see that? See that right there? We're gonna go for it.
Okay, one punch to Frank.
I move too, fool. Shit. Shit, I'm.
Hey, I was watching the phone. Did that like two camps ago with Rafa?
Were you
so
drunk outside?
I was watching the
other game. Ellie, I get home. I think
Paul from Paicoma. Paicoma. Hey, ain't that where Richie Valens was from? Paicoma? Yeah, they said, give us a shout out, Robert. Right there. I know what I'm doing. Yeah, good. Dude, I'm pretty fast. Hey, just so you fucking haters, I used to play football. I can do a 40-yard dash in 5-0 right now, and I'm weighing 300 pounds. So shut up.
Stop hating.
I posted a video like on my Instagram the other day.
Would eat that punch. I'll take a punch just so they know that I'm not afraid. I always take a punch. Yep. Huskies in the middle. Give us just a little. Huskies in the back. Show us where it's at. See, hey, where's that guy at? Caesar. Mikey versus Chuck Norris. If it's boxing, Mikey gots it. Chuck Norris probably do some crazy kick.
Bro, he got ran over. He's committed to the
ow, deep breathing, bro, because I'm sick right now.
You're not sick anymore?
What's up, man? More people showing up. Hey, if you guys want to get out training here at the RGBA gym, hit up bio. Modern Day, come on, bro. Modern Day, really? Hey, they got one good run. If Centennial's quarterback didn't go out, if he never went out, we would have won, bro. I don't run a 40 in 2 weeks, bro. Just to let you know, I run a 40 in five. Well, I used to run in five flat. I could. No, 40 is 4.6, 4.5.
You're lying. You did not run a 40.
I run a five flat in a 40. Not a 4.6. Five.
You're fucking lying. You're a liar.
I'm not lying. Dude, I'm not lying. I don't care what you said. I was a starter, dude. Outside linebacker, third string tight end. Oh, fullback. I got hands too, bro. Come on, guys. Stop talking shit. I was an athlete.
Gotcha.
Let's go to Hooters. I'll pay. Ow, which one? Hey. Go to Hooters. Hey, we can run. Just remember, Centennial Huskies. We got a Centennial Husky in camp. Hey, when's he turning pro? June 2nd? Isaac.
Isaac Colunga, June 2nd, at the what's the place called? Aguacaliente.
You know what I heard about Isaac? They said when he was in ninth grade, he came all tatted up to already football. They said he was the baddest, one of the baddest athletes in Centennial.
He's got a lot of fucking following. A lot of people going to show up to his fight. Louis on the same card. Louis on June 2nd. And so is... So it's Ruben Rodriguez.
Louis, where can they follow you at?
Hey, but talk about that, how Isaac was a freshman and walking around before the games, you don't have your pads on, he's walking around.
With tattoos, gangster, Centennial. Hey, Centennial, the only school that's not private, that's winning Pac-5 championships.
But he was fucking bad.
Yep.
His size is what he said.
Everybody from Corona is badass, so that's all I got to say about that. Shut up. Blake Barnett, the best pure athlete from Centennial. I don't know.
Isaac
cracked. Isaac, hey, I asked the Centennial coaches, and they said Isaac was one of the best athletes ever at a Centennial, and he was undersized, and he was, I think he played cornerback. Now he's going to be in boxing. June 2nd. You guys heard it there first. And he's from Colton.
Aguacaliente.
Yeah, that's
the fight's going to be. So, come and support. Three of our guys. Luis Cordia, Ruben Rodriguez, and Isaac Colugna.
You guys heard it there from Robert. Come and support. We'll be there in a couple weeks. Hey, bro, Finland High School in Ohio, you guys might have good football players, but not Centennial. Centennial is ranked, almost won national titles both past couple years. We lost by one game closely. Is Mikey high? No, man, come on. Mikey don't. He's high on life. Ow, high on life. Nah, I cater. Cali football is nothing on Texas football. Dude, Texas football had some good comparing. Hey, but
Rafa wasting his time over here in high and fucking Riverside when he's fucking eating at
he's eating good.
Mastro's fucking nice fucking clothes and everything. What the fuck?
Robert would even say, why even ask that, but that's dumb. Robert versus Mikey, who wins? Come on, that's dumb. They don't fight the brothers. And plus, he would know Mikey wins. No, Robert's the best trainer, and Mikey's the best fighter. You got the perfect pair right there, and the best underneath coach right there.
best camp manager in the world.
No, I'm camp manager, fucker. I'm camp manager. 300.
Linares, Lomachenko.
What? For Mike?
Yeah, if I could line them up. No, but Crawford's still welterweight. So right now,
Pacquiao?
It would be, I would do Linares, Lomachenko, and Robert Issus or Beltran to
unify.
Ooh, Ray Beltran.
What do you call it? They call it undisputed, right?
Undisputed.
Yeah, the lightweight. You know, I think lightweight.
Like, oh,
we're gonna win all the titles at lightweight. Then we're going to go to 40.
See, look at all the money's coming in right now.
Then we'll go to...
Cha-ching, 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 cha-ching. I'm just kidding, bro.
Everybody's like this.
Hey, cha-ching. It's all money, man. Hey, you guys want to come over here and train with one of the best trainers? Go for it. Hey, what's up?
Yeah,
what? I can cater at your house in LA, but what you want, man? What you want? Hey, you got to buy the food, and then I'll go over there and cook it. I don't cook at my house. Robert versus Angel Garcia. Robert wins. Angel Garcia might pull out a gun, though, or some shit. He's crazy. Will Brandon Rios be back, Robert?
Yeah, Brandon's calling me every day if we really have something for him, but we're working on it. Sometimes we're thinking maybe June.
But I told him yesterday. He's happy. He said
I can do a push-up, but I just broke my arm, fucker. Can you do a push-up? I broke my arm, bro. I can't do shit right now with one bad arm. Come on, man. I grew up in the hood. You guys think I'm a punk, you little bastards? Come on, man. I survived.
Because that winner has one belt or two belts? One belt.
Hold on, man. You guys are texting way too fast. I broke my arm a couple months ago, so my arm's bad. I can't do shit right now.
And then when you fight for that WBO,
barely holding the camera.
The ring or the WBO?
Allie, how's it feel to be world famous?
I don't know. Ask Mikey. Ask Robert.
You're the star. Everybody wants to take pictures with you.
Let me show people your eyes. Forget being a star.
Shut up. I wish I was high. Been dealing with Mike all day. I'm freaking stressed out of my mind. I need a beer.
What do you think about Frank?
He's funny, but...
But I need to make money. I need to make money. That's the bottom line. Good.
Hire you right here. Because I honestly need... But if I haven't seen nothing... I haven't seen your work.
Well, I can work, okay, man. Work, you can't work see. You can't even vouch for me. What a dick.
Work for us for 2 weeks for free. And then we'll know. Okay? Because we don't know.
I'm established. I work with world champions. I work with world champions, Robin. I'm established. I don't care what anyone says.
He does more than cooking. He does PR.
I'm not extorting Mike, fuckers. I'm making him money, bastards. All you guys do is talk shit. Just follow me, frantic one. But follow Louis first. What? Spell out your Instagram.
Instagram, KingLouis416.
Okay, what's your Instagram? Name your social media?
Hector W. Escobar.
W. Escobar?
Are you related okay. to Pablo?
Team Mikey Garcia right there.
Hector Escobar. That's a fucking badass fucking last name.
Amigo?
I have a one, frantic one. F-R-A-N-T-I-K _O-N-E. But please don't refer girls. I need a lot of girls following me. I don't need dudes following me. I need some hot chicks. So if you guys got sisters or moms, have them follow me. Yeah, I do sisters or moms. Pork Chop. I don't know where he's at, but I heard he wants Ryan Garcia.
What happened to that fight?
Make that happen. Hey, him and Neno. That would be good fights for Brooklyn. That show.
New gloves?
Hey, you can get him a Chevron sponsor. You don't need to tell Mikey. Call me up for that, man. Fuck, Renee. Come on, man. Tag me. Don't give him a Chevron. You got to go through me first.
Hey, Frank, how come you haven't got us any
sponsors? I told you I'm working on that one. I got the pictures. Oh, yeah. I guarantee you I'll get that one.
Robert.
I'll get it. I'll get that one.
Mikey's with his belt. So
he didn't want to take one today. We had the IBF belt. I know. We need to hire. This is what we need. We need to set up a studio time. We need posters. We need shit. Yeah.
We're gonna drive it over there. We're gonna drive it to Josito's fight.
Where's he fighting?
I'll call Michael to come do it.
Fucking dick, man. I swear.
Puzzle, Texas.
Oh, nice.
Mikey, can you give Pacoma a shout out, please?
I'll have Michael come and do it.
Can you give him a shout out, please? Ball 12. Malo. There you go. I can lose 30 pounds by next fight. Yeah. I can lose pounds. If you hire me, I'll lose weight.
Still, yeah, I'll lose the weight. You don't know what I can do, Mike. Hey, when I'm motivated, I can lose a lot of weight. I can do a lot of things.
I've never seen you lose weight.
Because you didn't have a hot chick around. You need to have a hot chick around to get motivated. Who wins, Mikey or De La Hoya? Mikey, bro. De La Hoya, he had a good left and good fighter, but Mikey wins. He's better defensive fighter.
Now, let's say Robert and Mikey are not here. How would you answer?
I would still say Mikey. He was my favorite fighter when I was a kid because I like watching him, but you're a better defensive fighter. I'm not lying. What? And he fought everybody. And I liked him because he fought everybody. Like Mikey does. Mikey would fight a Bernard Hopkins if he had the opportunity. Hey, you would, right? He said wants to fight Lara. Be good against Lara.
Lara is 160.
I'm fake skin. Orale. Yeah, you're right. I'm fake skin. Yeah, bro. You're right. You know my life story. What's your name? Alimonto? What the fuck is that? Ellie, are you like, no, Ellie Momento. What is that? But that's his name. That's his name? That's his name. That's his screen name. But why would you put that as your screen name? Well, he is high.
Frantic one.
Well, I'm frantic. That's why I am frantic all the time. $3,000 for appearance, you got yourself. As long as 1 hour appearance, and then you need to supply some shirts, too. So, yeah, we can make that happen. He gets 20 or 2,000 something. No, buy shirts and stuff. See, it's not. You think I make money. I buy shirts, I buy posters, and we make the whole thing work. I just don't pocket money. Fucking A.
No.
Huh?
I paid you in advance.
All right. Frank should charge for guest appearances. All right. Sorry, yeah, I'm charging for Mike's guest appearances. Whatever you guys going to have birthday party instead of having somebody
Frank,
jump out of the cake.
Get us a fucking sponsor.
I'm working on it, Robert. I'll get it. I have to. Time for talking is over. Rain is Robert sparring again. What Robert? Robert don't spar, does he? Yep, I extorts Mikey money. You're right. You got me. You freaking got me. Endurance trainer.
People don't believe him that he knows you.
What I do for a living is I freaking hear and I hustle and I try to make money here and there. And I'm on marketing company and I work on the side, bro.
In 96, Olympics,
96?
No, 92, 92, my bad.
I'll ask him, hold on. What's ETA on the new gym, though? What do you mean on the new gym? It's right here. Stop the
tournaments. We room together.
Ow.
Heavyweight, black.
Come on, bro.
Fuck.
Come on, man. Nope, the Raiders are winning the Super Bowl this year, bro. Gruden's back. Chucky's back. I wish I was a millionaire. I wish I was a millionaire. I wish I was a millionaire. Allie should hire me. Yep, you're right. No, my grandfather's from Michoacan, not me. Frank sells dope, I used to. Not no more. I gave up before I got caught, bro. Real truth. Where the weed at? Wow. It's in my car somewhere in Moreno Valley. I just carry enough around. Can't get busted with the lot.
Donald.
Nah. You know what? Triple G Canelo might be canceled. I don't know. I don't know how serious the things are. We don't know if it's a publicity stunt. We don't know none of that stuff, man. It might be publicity. It's going to get everybody more interested. I want to see now, you know, more of a Canelo Triple G just to see how it goes, just because they implemented in the head. You know what? Canelo might have done drugs or, you know, Paulie Malignaggi says he probably did them. So, you know, Paulie probably has a good insight, but who really knows? But the truth of the matter of fact is, I still want to see him fight, and I want to see him fight Triple G, and it makes it more interesting now. So, all right, no cussing, no kids here. You're right.
Orange County in the house. What's up, Orange County?
It was Larry Down, right?
Yeah.
I knew it.
Larry Down.
Larry Down.
What was that?
He's hating, bro, for no reason. It's no biggie for me.
I used to roommate with him.
I will smoke a Super Bowl when the Raiders are playing. You're right. Hey, the sun's right here. So, all right, there we go. A welder. Can you, do you need anything welded, Robert? If you need anything welded, you need anything welded around the gym?
Not right now.
Not right now. We'll hit you. When you build it bigger, you need a welder?
All this is going to be the gym. The whole, should be like a 6-square-foot gym. Right there, all that.
Okay, whoever texts that they need a welder, you need to come. All right, the whole yard, so. Right here, if you want to come and weld and help out and donate your time, go ahead. All right here. He's going to make this extended part. Richard, if you can be a security, you have to go through me, bro. Sorry. I don't ask Mikey about that. Robert's gym in San Antonio is on what street again?
Are you going to help him?
Bandera Street. Right across street from the liquor store. Bandera Road. All right. Nah, I'm not a pound for pound weed smoker. I used to be. I'm slowing down, man. How much for boxing classes, Pita? Pita. They want to know. Huge shout out from UK. All right. Thanks, UK.
That's what I was thinking of the mic when you
say. Hey, what do you guys think? Okay, this for your English people. Hey, would you guys want to see? Well, it's on pay-per-view there, or they get it for free?
In England.
Do they get it?
Pay-per-view is $14.
In England, it's pay-per-view.
Pay-per-view is $14.
Hey, how many of the Mexican fans on here will order?
Mexican fans.
But we'll ask both. Joshua versus Parker. Would you guys order that on Cinco de Mayo? Just give your thoughts here on pay-per-view, because we had a big argument and everybody said I was stupid, but I think it would work out on Cinco de Mayo. Pita, how much are your classes? How much are you? They want to know.
They're going to come show up. Yeah, they got to come. Nah, plus it's a different.
So none of you guys would order. Everybody's saying no, they won't order. But I don't think so. You guys don't know who they are? You guys don't know the heavyweights or what? Why wouldn't you order it?
Josh, where's the other one? I don't know.
Parker? He's fought one time on...
All I know is that Frank said, Joseph Parker, a letter, stop using your logo because you're copying Mike and I'm going
to... Mikey, Lomachenko's following you. Good, he should be following us. They want to see how we do things. So does Terrence Crawford. He follows our camp life. Camp life. Shout out for New Zealand. No, I'm not mad. I'm watching the Canelo fight. No, Robert does not have a gym in Dallas right now. What does it say, Frank? How do I get in touch with you? Hit me up on Instagram, man. Frantic one. FRANTIK _NE. Only Joshua Water. So you guys would order Joshua fight on Cinco de Mayo. That's what I'm talking about. Joseph Bonas. Who's Joseph Bonas?
He's a young prospect from Detroit, but he's a troublemaker, so I think he's locked up right now. But he was bad. He was a good-ass amateur.
Oh, okay, you guys heard it there.
Yeah, it was
2-0.
Samoan power. Yep, Samoan power.
I'm telling you, right there. Future Culiacan.
Right there. Champion. You heard it right there. Future world champion.
Future Culiacan. He's 9-0, 9 knockouts right now.
I know, we need a reality show. You're right.
What's your last name?
Turn pro, 12 years old, Mexico.
¿Cómo se llama?
Otra vez.
Hector Escobar.
Escobar. Hector Escobar.
Esco Pablo Escobar.
Met you in Universal Studios Friday.
Is your nickname
last year? Are you sure you met me? I haven't been in Universal Studios. When did you meet me? Was it? I put gutters in your house. Oh, you met Mikey. Some guy put gutters at your house and he met you at Universal Studios. He says, what's up? Some guy met you at Universal Studios and he put gutters in your house.
What's his name?
Jose? Oh, let me see. Jose Perez. On you, he met you on Friday the 13th last year in Universal Studios. You were there? Yeah, he met you. What's up? So Fort Worth, San Diego, Angel. Do you have a sister named Angela, bro? I miss Angela Martinez.
Does it happen or no?
How much for an IG post? It depends on what you want. For who? For Mike? It depends what you want, but I'll make it worth your due. I can't say it over the thing because then everybody steals my price points, which took me a long time to figure it out. House, no queen.
What the fuck,
God? What?
Your price points take you a long time to find out.
Yeah. What happened? They want to know for Mikey for an Instagram post. I don't give that shit out for free.
How much is it?
I don't give it.
Post.
Charlie, hit me up.
Privately, because then people steal my price points.
Yep. Damn right.
Directly, bro.
No. Mike will give it away for free.
Hit me up directly.
No, hit me up. Don't hit Mike up. Hit me up. I'll make it worth your deal. I'll make sure it gets done.
Shut up. What did you call it?
The
resurrection?
The rejuvenation, Josecito Lopez, not the veteran. See, call PBC up and tell him to redo that, Mike. Tell him to redo that post. I'm being serious.
What are you talking about?
But Mike has to promote his fighters in a different way, not a veteran. He's rejuvenated. He's RGBA. He's hungry.
I was a veteran, too. Brian Villoria was a veteran when he came to me, too. Abner Mares is
a veteran.
You know what I mean? They're veterans. So what?
I don't run no 10-second 40, bro. See? Freaking haters, dude. Everything's so slow, man. I ain't slow. Fuckers.
Hey, watch your language.
Oh, yeah. Sorry. Forgot. Which house? He said, "Which house ballin'?" Exactly. Hey, they said, "Which house ballin'?" He's moved a couple. Well, it was last year, buddy. He's bought a couple properties.
Hey, how long did it take you to get back from Mikey's fight? Mikey was away in Belize for 11 days, and you guys got back at the
same time. Yeah.
I took a long tour, man.
The gun that was in your car illegally?
Bastard. Threw me out. I could have got arrested in Arizona.
Couldn't,
fuck.
But didn't, so you're fine.
But yeah. Did you die?
Yes, Ellie is a pound-for-pound Jew.
So wait, what happened?
You Ali,
how to be friends with the Jew?
But you believe in Jesus now, Ali, right?
No.
Huh?
No, it's not my religion.
I don't think you have a religion, Ali. I don't think you have a religion. I don't pull no hamstring, bro. I can handle. Let's play some football. We'll
Frank,
see.
Why did it take you 2 weeks to get back?
I went to Tombstone, Bisbee. I went to see Selena. I met Abraham Quintana. Hey, Abraham's mean. Selena's dad, I met him. He's mean.
Abraham Quintana?
Yeah.
Quintanilla.
You said you want to be the new manager?
He's mean. I met him. I'm going to watch him.
Ow. Quintanilla.
Saldívar? Yolanda Saldívar?
No, she's dead, bro. She died. Shut up. Shut the fuck up, you idiot.
Yeah, that's going to be him.
Okay, yeah. Mike's going to kill me. He pulled...
Yolanda.
Mike would end up killing somebody before I knew.
Yeah.
You
have to go ask questions. How'd you do it? And this.
You're an idiot.
President of Mikey Garcia fan club.
It took a half hour to watch him and a half hour to watch 60 minutes. Bro, that's the... No, he's writing it to me. It's so stupid. It took him an hour and a half to watch 60 minutes. Hey, bro. Your mom got cut from the Raiders because I heard she was too rough. How about that one?
It's not even funny.
Huh?
It's not funny. It was weak.
She was too rough. She got cut. Armor Trucks. Does he like Amor Trucks? What's an Amor truck? That's his trucker. No, potato tacos. Queso cotija and cabbage and crema.
You're not supposed to eat no more meat?
Crema. Mikey don't even eat queso cotija. Hey, and do you eat beans? You eat beans, Friday? Right? Why you got Fridays?
Why are you not going
to
eat meat?
Because I'm tired of meat.
I miss your
Mike Aldo, huh? Hey, when Mikey had Mike Aldo, he was like this all the time. Now, I don't know. Somebody called him one night. He said no. Hey, what do you guys think would get you more pumped up? Caldo or ensalada or salads?
What is it? What?
Salads. Hector does salads. I do soups and broths and heavy beans.
In Spanish.
Ensalada.
Say in Spanish.
Ensalada.
No.
Caldo.
What?
Caldo.
Caldo.
I told you I have a speech problem, Robert.
Caldo.
Stop talking shit.
He's Mexican. Caldo.
I had a speech problem, Robert. Hater.
Caldo.
Frank for mayor. Ow, yo. Crown Town. Ali versus CM Punk. Why would Ali fight a wrestler? Come on, you guys. What are you guys doing?
Because I guess he sucked in the MMA, so.
Ooh, no, he only had one fight. Look at all the youngsters right there. Look at Hopes and Dreams. Right here.
Your future clients?
Hey. Clients. I better be nice, huh? Better be nice to the parents.
30% is a lot.
What, is that what he wants?
I don't charge 30%. No. Everybody's saying stuff. I don't even say that. What's up, San Antonio? Come on, I didn't even say that. Look at it. Pita at work. Right here.
All right, everybody inside.
Come on, bro. I don't have to run. I should run, but only run around girls. Oh. I don't charge 30%, Robert. Huh? Where's Paro? I don't know, bro. He's in Oxnard somewhere. He's not around here no more. It's good you watch all the videos, though. Thanks for the support. Hey, anybody who asked about Paro, or how do you guys say his name?
What?
I have a speech problem, Robert.
You can't speak Spanish.
Hey, but that shows that they support.
You can't speak Spanish.
They show that they support ES News and they watch all his videos. That's good. Camp Lice. Huh? Yeah, that means they're... That's good. Praise the Lord. Right, Mike?
Hey, what? You hate Lomachenko?
Who? I don't hate him. I don't even know him. Never even met him. Yeah, he does have skinny sweats on. I don't know what the reasoning behind that one is. But yeah, he does have skinny...
Frank ordered the sweats from Mikey and everybody got extra, extra small, but for himself, he got a normal size.
But I guess you liked it, so you kept with it, huh, Ellie? Oh, okay. What is that, medium or small? In kids?
Remember the one my dad tried to put them on? My dad tried to put them on. Fucking Frank, you fucked up.
What's next for Mikey?
Frank got his up, yeah, and for my dad? You got one of those fucking... My dad got mad, dude.
Why? I didn't order it. Mikey said he wanted the fitted look.
Yeah, but for yourself, you got a good one.
Yeah, whatever. Okay. Mike, what's the best advice you can get amateur boxers?
Don't hire Frank.
Fucking guy. You're all coked up with those good comebacks, aren't you? Freaking dude. Always wired, cracked out, or some shit.
Experience. Win or lose, just fight.
Just fight.
See, you guys heard it right there. From Robert himself.
The amateurs in the, like you used to think, people used to think amateurs used to be amateurs, you know, Olympics.
It's hard.
It's hard, and it's politics, and sometimes it's not.
Right now, if I'm not mistaken, you know, for the...
He's relaxing.
The Olympics, I think there's the weight division that, like here in the United States, that already has the guy representing the Olympics, the team.
2 years
ahead. Uh-huh. What? And even if they do the Olympic trials and all that shit, there's nothing because they already have the guy that's going to go.
That's messed up, no headgear. So why not be
amateur? Or before, or there's that's the Olympics too. You know, because I know Genaro Gomez, my
what's
boy,
up,
Genaro Gomez, Hector Tanahara. They were both 132 pounders. And they could have fought in the Olympic trials, but even whoever would have won it still wasn't going to go to the Olympics because they already had Valderas going to the Olympics. So, you know, to me, it doesn't make sense. But on points or whatever, however they do it, they select that guy, Valderas, I guess, because maybe he won some other tournaments. So they selected him to go to the Olympics before even the trials happened. Before it used to be, you gotta fucking win the trials and then win the box-offs to go to the Olympics. Yeah?
Yep.
Before. Right now, it doesn't work like that.
The point system changed, and you're racking up points over the years with different tournaments. So if you accumulate enough points in the first 2 years, you know, the last year might not even matter. You've already accumulated so many points that they cannot catch up to you.
Look, there was, you know, Tanahara, Valderas, the kid from there that went to Honduras, Teofimo Lopez, same thing. And those, and all three could fucking fight. All three, look, I'm not making it up. The last tournament before the Olympics, the National Pals in Oxnard, Tanahara beat Valderas on a decision, but still couldn't, you know, they still didn't have the tournaments like they normally do, the Olympic trials. And then from the trials, the top two go to the box office to represent the United States. They don't do that anymore. So Valderas was already scheduled to go to the Olympics, so Tanahara, Teofimo Lopez, Genaro Gomez, what was the point of fucking going to the trials if they had no chance anyways?
That's where you messed up, though. If you lose,
it is kind of messed up.
That's why it's not like if your goal is to make it in the pros, you know, don't take the amateurs too serious when it comes to a loss.
And I'm not taking anything away from Carlos Valdera. Because that kid can really fight. He's the real deal. Richard Schaefer signed him, and that kid is really good. He's gonna be a badass world champion, superstar. He is really good. I'm not saying my guys or Teofimo would have beat him. I'm not saying that either. I'm just saying there was no trials like they normally do, the trials, the box-ups, and all that bullshit. They didn't do it.
But Robert, being around amateurs now, I realize that some of them work just as hard as pro.
Hold on, you guys.
2 days, 3 days, the diet. Right. Like, they're doing it for free. So why not turn pro if you're already so dedicated?
When they're 18, most of them turn pro.
There's a kid in LA, in Tarzana. He's 17 years old. Top Rank just signed him. He can only fight in Texas and... 17.
Nevada? Nevada,
that's it.
Nevada,
Philadelphia.
And Nevada's going to be very hard. But Nevada's very hard. Yeah. They want nothing but hard fights. I have Joseph Adorno. Who,
he's the greatest last fight.
Who is, who knows, what is it, 6-0 with six knockouts? Yep. Joseph Adorno, he was 17 when I signed him with Top Rank 2. And
get closer.
And our plan was to turn him pro on a November on a Lomachenko undercard in Vegas. But me and Brad were opponents, sending him into the commission.
Rejected.
A 17-year-old making his pro debut. They wanted a fucking solid, hard fight. So we waited.
Hold on, Jose.
Pro in Philadelphia. To sell Philadelphia allows 17-year-olds. So we turned him pro in Philadelphia. A 17-year-old, he's still a kid. So why was Nevada rejecting all the... We had opponents, you know, maybe 1-3 or 2-3, and they still rejected all those opponents. They said, no.
Well, they wanted to fight a guy 18-0?
They wanted to fight somebody, you know, a 17-year-old, that's a kid. You still don't know his reaction. But, you know, he's 6-0 now, 6 knockouts, doing good. He's 18 now. So we're pushing him good. We're, Top Rank's doing a great job with him.
So you guys heard it there. That's their opinion on the amateur boxing. So there you heard it. First on Frank's news reporting. All right, good job. Good job. Hey, Mike, what's the best headgear for real fast, in your opinion?
Winning.
And they want to know why they call you Grandpa back in the day, Robert.
Since I was like 12 years old.
They want to know why, though.
I've been Grandpa since I was 12 years old.
Okay. So you guys heard it there. You don't want to know.
No, what is it?
Fat Frank forever.
Fat Frank.
Forever.
And he used to... Fucking 5 seconds sprint. Over.
I did. I was. Yeah, I'm fast. 40, not lying.
Four
40 yards in 5 seconds. Five seconds.
NFL superstar doing a 4.4. So he was half a second off.
I was fast. I don't care if you believe me. I was a starter on football, superstar Centennial football, 4.4. Class of '95, bro.
Was just half a second.
Right there.
Right there.
Hey, you heard it there.
Frank,
let's see.
You said Mikey needs strength and conditioning. What else does Mikey need to change?
That's it.
Oh, that's it, Mikey. That's all you're missing.
That's it. That's it. He has everything else. Mike, you already know Moss. Why you keep going after him? Who is this guy? He's from some other country. He don't like you, Mike, because you're beating all the...
Remember that guy? Check this out.
He beating all the Russians.
When
and
I
were...
the fights were here in...
India.
In India. Remember the guy that was... When we were doing that phone thing?
Yes, that guy that was
telling us to give... What's his name? A chance.
Shosho Brown, what's up, bro?
Yes, that
he
guy,
fucking
the fighter called
out.
Me to tell me to take down the video before. He's like,
but
I
got,
called out my
I don't know what happened, Tapia. Hold on, man.
In India?
Yeah, he's with Golden Boy.
I know.
Willis from Canada, shout out. You want it from Reiki or Mike? Hold on. We're right here with ES News.
How many people are alive?
We got 400
Gibson,
people.
Gibson. Okay, so...
Hold on.
Why doesn't Mikey give Kendrick Gibson a chance? Mikey, give Kendrick Gibson a chance. So I'm walking to the arena.
What's up, Pancho?
They haven't opened the doors, so there's a lot of people in line. But then there's this guy. He's like, "Hey, Robert." So I'm like, "What?" So I went to shake his hand. He's like, "What's Mikey gonna give Kendrick Gibson a chance?" I'm like, "What are you talking about?" Kendrick Gibson, yeah, Mikey's afraid of Kendrick Gibson, you know, talking shit.
See, right,
like,
there.
Dude.
The guy's laughing.
Fight today.
You're right, Robert, the guy's laughing. The one who's talking shit is
okay,
him. He's laughing.
It. So look.
Robert caught you, bro.
So he's talking shit. Kendrick Gibson, this, Mikey. And then, you know, people started like, what's wrong with that dude? You know, people were asking.
What's up, Lewis?
And this guy kept saying.
No, Corona Centennial, bro.
Signed the contract. Sign the contract. Fight
Tacos de Papa, I'm eating today.
So,
I go in, right? Security, or Melita. Actually, security came because he was fucking just being rude. Security took me inside. So when I'm inside, after
Sergio,
I went outside to watch a fight, and a lot of people. Robert, let's
Woodcrest.
So this guy comes with his phone. So Robert, right here, you're on camera. So you're telling me Mike's afraid of Kendrick Gibson? I'm like, dude. Step away.
See, Kendrick Gibson what? Will be Mike. I can run, bro.
Signed the contract, you know. Así sigue el cabrón.
Not right now, but I can run.
Everybody's like, dude, what's wrong with you? And, you know, he was just talking shit. So I go back he wants inside, Danny and Garcia. Kendrick Gibson is in my fucking same locker room. So I told Kendrick Gibson, hey, dude, you got some, you know, friend of yours out there. They knew we were like, oh, they even said his name. They're like, don't listen to him. He's fucking, you know, he's an idiot. Everybody's telling me he's an idiot. His own team. And then Kendrick Gibson, and I'm not making fun of Kendrick Gibson. He goes and gets knocked out. He got knocked out in the second round. So what does this guy got to say now? You know what I mean? You know what I mean? I'm nothing against Kendrick Gibson, but that dude makes
all right, hold on.
Us say that to
Kendrick Gibson. Who was that one fighter you fought? Who had the friend like that? I was talking all this guy in New York.
Rojas. Oh, Rojas. Yeah. Same kind of fool. Same kind of fool.
Yeah. Gamboa, I was that one like that too.
They same all kind of fool, yeah. So after Kendrick Gibson got knocked out,
it's the wind blowing, fool. I'm not even breathing.
Nobody knew where that guy was. I'm telling you, Kendrick Gibson right there was a gentleman, nice with
what's
me.
What's up?
You know, his manager, that attorney from Texas, from San Antonio, Texas.
He actually reached out to me, Kendrick, after we did this video. He said, please take it down. It wasn't me. See, I'm not the one calling.
See?
That one guy. And I told him, look.
See, what's up, Ivory?
Yes.
And that's how Frank sometimes acts.
Oh, well, like what? I don't do that shit.
Yeah, you do.
Stop, Mike. See, you're always talking shit. I'm not even breathing. I went off PPC. A floor on Showtime. Floor, you need to get your attitude straight. I'm being straight up. Floor on Showtime. She needs to get her shit straight. Indica, bro. Indica all the way. When you're young, sativa. When you're older, indica.
It makes it look bad. And then he loses. So, you know what I mean? It sucks for Kendrick. You know, I didn't wish him that. But that's who fucking...
That guy keeps laughing. You were right, Robert. He keeps putting the smiley face. It is him.
That's probably him.
It is. See, you're undercover and he caught you. Ow. Okay, see, you heard it there first, man. That's what Mikey says. See, you're talking shit and they knew who you were. You got caught, bro. Check in my boxing bag workout on Instagram, South Paul King. Hit me up on Frantic One, FRANTIKONE _ONE.
Not the one to get in the ring.
Exactly.
Yeah. He can talk and everything. Yeah. There's a lot more to get in the ring. He can talk all he wants.
Look, no dabs. Dabs are bad for you.
He goes in and don't gets do dabs. You know,
Frank's against dabs.
It sucks.
See? Mikey's not faded. He's tired. He hasn't ate since the morning and he ate ice cream, so he needs to eat. That's about it. What's the best dish? Is Siete Mares. That's my best dish. No, I don't got no snap chops. Why are dabs bad? Dabs are bad because it makes you look like a crack addict when you're smoking a shit. Sativa daytime only. Sativa is good at Magic Mountain. It's agua chilies. It's a ceviche, and it's mixed with the cocktail, the camarón. That's a campechana.
Corona, why do you have an accent like you're from?
That's what it is. That's what they told me, Robert. Real Mexicans told me. Lick your culo. Is it a jaina? You're a freaking guy licking culos. You're sick fag. Why are there gay people all over? Lick my culo. Really? A gay person? I hope you're not a dude who said that. Lick my culo. You're a nasty fuck. And you probably use cheap toilet paper too, you sick fuck. Dang, Tony, you must be sending. What's up, Shushu? Let's see. Tell Mikey congrats on his win. Thanks, Genesis. Dang. See, that's a good fan right now. Congratulations.
Is that guy still there?
Hey, why do Mayweather fans hate on Mike? You know what? Because, now I don't know if they hate on him. Mayweather don't hate on Mike, or I don't think his fans do. What's up?
Why are you from Corona, but you have an accent that you're very Caucasian?
A la Diabla. Camarones a la Diabla. Yeah, those are good. They're spicy. They get you heartburn, though. You can't cook those for fighters during training camp. It will give them heartburn.
What?
La Bufadora. Yeah, I think I had it one time, and that's the one in... The Bufador is in Paris, and it's in Rosarito, right? They have one in Rosarito, right? La Bufador.
No,
it's Ensenada, you're right.
I'm just talking about the tacos, though.
Oh, hey, you know what? I have a speech problem, bro, so that's the truth. I don't care what you guys say. It's like Americanized, bro. I don't wipe. Ow, I figured that shit, you sick fuck. You and your store-bought toilet paper. Frank's scared of wax. I'm not scared of wax. It just makes you look like a dope addict. I'm sorry, bro, but all natural shit. Hey, Mike, we better get going, though. Hey, Ali, you're going to pay me for freaking hosting your freaking website? Come on, Ali. Hey, okay, so tell Robert I make sell custom Riverside bells. And look, if you give Robert a bell, he'll hang it up.
A what?
A bell. Would you hang a Riverside bell? Like bell, the ring, like they make Riverside bells.
Oh, yeah.
I'm gonna fuck he'll hang it.
Tell him you want 30%.
20%. Hey, can you make me one, though, too? I'll hang one. No. Yeah, we got to go, man. So thanks. Yeah, DM me, and if it's for sponsorships, I'll take it all over. DM me.
How many times are you going to promote
yourself? Hey, Richard Sanchez, you're 45-0 on the streets?
Correct.
Ow, you're not in the pinta yet?
Mikey Garcia.
I hope you're president of a gang or some shit if you're 45-0, bro, on the streets. I got jumped a couple times, and I went undefeated, too, so. Yep, he is going to be the greatest of all time. Yeah.
I got jumped a couple times.
You fought him off?
Brandon lives in Oxnard, and Riverside's quite a bit of a drive. So we're going to be taking off. Thanks for you guys watching. Follow me on Frank News Reporting, a YouTube channel coming soon. The takeover's over, and I'm giving it back. Allie.
Thanks so much for tuning in.
Don't forget to say
la fecha.
Reporting. We'll be back.